Hello and welcome back to Ek Umeed Help YouTube channel. This is another video of Spring Boot tutorial series. Thank you for all your support. Please do hit a like button and subscribe this channel. Okay, well, this is the last video related to Spring Boot configuration. In this video, we are going to take a look at properties with profile. So we already discussed different approach to configure a Spring Boot application, whether it would be a property file or YAML file. So now I am going to cover one more topic that is related to a Spring Boot profile. How to manage a different profile for different environment. So whether if you are working in a dev environment or in a prod environment, you have to manage it, right? So what we can do, like we can configure an active profile either in application.property file or application.yml file. And based on that, if you have a multiple file spread in your application and has the same property, so based on that profile name, Spring Boot bring the value from the active profile and give the priority to the active profile, and manage based on that you can manage your Spring Boot application. So I'll show you, let's jump into the Eclipse and show you the code how we can manage it. Okay, so this is my application, and this one is application.property and this one is application.yml. You already know, right? So let me add here the profile, like spring.profiles.active is equal to dev. So I have added this one dev, and the next step what I need to do is go to this application, create others file. Okay, the name of the file is application-dev dot properties properties. Okay, so this is like you can use that application is the prefix and dev is that extension. You can use dev dot properties for your file name. Okay, so and what I'm going to do is I'm copying this file here, okay, this attributes you can say, and change me in dev, change me in dev. Okay, and let me run the application and see the result what happened. Okay, so now see that. Okay, now application is running. It takes some time, few second to start. Okay, now you can see this change me in dev is coming, right? So how it is coming? Just because we have added one property with a name like spring.profile.active is equal to dev. That means Spring gave the priority to the active profile and override the property, whatever property. If you have the same property in two different file, override the property that is mentioned in your active profile. So dev is my active profile, so this property get overridden. So this way you can configure in your application.property file, and let me show you the same thing in YML. Okay, so I'm using this three dot is a separator, file separator. Hyphen is the file separator, and then I am writing Spring. Okay, Spring 1, 2, 3, 4. As I told you, this is that indentation you have to follow. Spring dot profile, and profile is equal to, let me give a profile name is dev. Okay, so this is my profile name that I have. So file separator and then profile. What is the active profile? This is the dev is my profile, active one. And in the dev, I'm going to add contact. Okay, and what is the contact? email ID. So let me copy this and paste it here. dev-email ID. Okay, and let me see, check the result. Now it is, now you can see this override. Okay, so the data that is available in your active profile that get overridden. So by this way you can configure your application in different environment. So you can create a 3 application dot dev, application dot prod, application dot QA, and configure your properties, and based on that, whatever your active, you just change the active profile in this property file, or in file separator you can change the profile name, and based on that you can easily deploy your application. So that's it. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe.